आजकल का जो सिनेमा है और उसका जो ग्रामर है, मैं आपको थोड़ा विस्तार में बता दूं अगर दो मिनट हैं तो।
जी,
क्या है, कैमरा फोटोग्राफी से आया है, एक्टिंग थिएटर से आया है, राइटिंग तो राइटिंग से है, संगीत की दुनिया से है, क्लासिकल फोक एंड ऑल दैट। एक एडिटिंग ही ऐसा आर्ट फॉर्म है सिनेमा, जो सिर्फ सिनेमा की वजह से आया है, ये सिर्फ 100 साल पुराना है। और ये दिस इज द मोस्ट, कहते हैं ना, द बेबी आर्ट फॉर्म इन द वर्ल्ड ऑफ आर्ट, इन द वर्ल्ड ऑफ सिनेमा। हम सब मिलके बनाते हैं, इज अ कोलैबोरेटिव आर्ट। तो एडिटिंग अपने साथ एक्सपेरिमेंट कर रहा है। आजकल सब डिजिटल हो गया है तो हम स्टोरी को नॉन लीनियर भी बोल पा रहे हैं। मतलब पहले बिगनिंग से शुरू करते थे, 1, 2, 3, 4 से 10 तक जाते थे, अब 2 से 12, 12 से ये। एट द सेम टाइम हम आपके ख्यालों में भी घुस सकते हैं कि बाजे वक्त आप ट्रेन में बैठी हैं बट आपको याद अपने बचपन की आ रही है, तो वी कैन आगे पीछे वो दोनों स्टोरियां चला सकते हैं। तो बहुत सिनेमा के जगत में बहुत ज़्यादा डेवलपमेंट हो रही है। ये सिर्फ 100 साल पुराना आर्ट फॉर्म है, आगे चलेंगे तो अभी वर्चुअल और ये सब ऑगमेंटेड रियलिटी और ये सब आने वाला है, एडिटिंग तो फिर पीछे रह जाएगी।
नहीं, लेकिन मेरा सवाल ये है कि दो कहानियाँ और बहुत खूबसूरत कहानियाँ, उन्हें जोड़ते वक्त आपको बहुत खूबसूरत से जो दृश्य आपने या गुलजार साहब ने लिखे होंगे वो काटने पड़ते होंगे।
इतनी प्यारी स्क्रिप्ट हो, फिर उसको आप सब लोग मेहनत से काम करते हैं और उसको शूटिंग करते हैं और बहुत मटीरियल होता है हमारे पास, और बट एंड में जो कहते हैं कि फिल्म टेबल पे बनती है, एक फिल्म का स्क्रीन प्ले कभी ख़त्म नहीं होता। एक लिखा जाता है, एक शूट किया जाता है, फिर एक्टर्स उसको अपनी तरह से इंटरप्रेट करते हैं, डायरेक्टर अपनी तरह से, म्यूजिक डायरेक्टर्स अपनी तरह से, कैमरामैन, फिर एडिटर के पास जब वो पहुँचती है बात तो वो अपनी तरीके से इंटरप्रेट करती हैं उन्हें, और फिर वो उस कहानी को वैसे बताते हैं। तो स्क्रीन प्ले बार बार लिखा जाता है और जब ऑडियंस देखती है, हर एक ऑडियंस का मेंबर उसको अपने हिसाब से इंटरप्रेट करता है।
वर्क कर दिया जाए, मतलब यू नो, विद हैविंग सम मसल्स आल्सो, दैट थॉट हैड कम इन योर माइंड, कुड यू टॉक, एंड हर्ष आल्सो, हर्ष से पूछा जाएंगे कि वो अपने डैड की तरह ही, यू नो, लाइक ही आल्सो हैज मेंटेन्ड हिमसेल्फ
राइट फ्रॉम सोहेल
जी।
ओके, द कैरेक्टर ऑफ दिस फिल्म, आई थिंक वी गॉट टू यूज्ड टू दिस सिक्स पैक्स दिस इज नंबर 1। नो, ये भेड़ चाल जो है। Number 2, Mirza's character was not that of a boxer. Neither. So Harsh has given me 18 months. Now, hear me out. Since we are talking about prep.
Yeah.
18 months before the shooting, don't get me wrong. In that, he has worked on the role of first the contemporary character, which is Munish in the film. So for them, in their first film, they are actually doing double roles in their first debut film. And that character required a certain physicality. Correct? Then after finishing that, we took a 7-month break because they had to prepare in a different way for another film within a film for another character to be in a different zone altogether. It's not easy, and in your first film. For 6 months, they prepared again. There is something called horse riding and mounted archeries. If you study that, when you are a horse rider, you got a very lean and athletic look about you. You don't have a six-pack look about you and all that. So I'm sure when we make a movie about a boxer, we'll satisfy you.
Harshvardhan, yahan mera sawal aapse hai. जब आपने पहली बार ये स्क्रिप्ट सुनी, आपका रिएक्शन क्या था?
Well, first of all, we actually met in 2008, I think, and we kept meeting every couple of months after that. And at the time, Rakesh sir had mentioned that he was working on the story of Mirza Sahiba, and Gulzar sahab was writing a screenplay. And I was actually still in college at that time. Mm-hmm. I was what, 18, 19 years old. I'm 25 now, so this is a conversation that's been going on for a very long time. And then I went back to college after the first interaction with Rakesh sir, and I actually did what I could, try to find whatever I could about the story on the internet. And You know, obviously it's a romantic tragedy, and it's very different from the other romantic tragedies because it's the two lovers themselves that make decisions that eventually determine their destiny. You know, so it was very complex and it was very brief and very vague on social media. So as kind of time went on, we kept reconnecting, and then eventually, I think in June 2013, after talking for like 2 or 3 years, we finally decided that it was the right time to kind of embark on this journey. And until then, I hadn't really heard anything from the script. So then finally, I sat with Mehra, and then he narrated about 10 or 15 pages because the script was still a work in progress at that time. Mm-hmm. And just the beauty that which it was kind of written, because you know, it's very rare these days to find scripts that are very poetic and very romantic. And I think for me, you know, I read it when I was 22, and I was reading so many other romantic stories and scripts, but I think that this is the most contemporary romantic film ever, you know, I mean, at least from what I've read the interpretation of it. You know, so I was completely blown away. I it's one of those things that you hear it and you're like, I have to. Anything, I'll give anything to be a part of this film, you know. I mean, it's romantic, it's complex, you get to play two characters, it's poetic, it's visual, it's musical. So it's like a fever dream, you know. So it's a dream.
Kitna difficult tha aapke liye is character ko nibhana?
To actually do kirdaar hai, ek Adil ka aur ek Mirza ka. To first we worked on Adil a lot. Actually we worked on both simultaneously when I heard the story, I knew that, you know, the whole film depends on my ability as a rider and an archer. Because Mirza is the best, you know, and I'd never been on a horse. So it sounds very easy, but actually when you start doing it, you know, and then you know the script, so you know how sir is going to shoot it. It's not like other films where, you know, you cut to a close-up and then you cut to the stunt double. It's not one of those films. Mm-hmm. You know, I knew the level that I had to kind of reach to. And I moved away to Delhi for 6 months first, because, you know, Bombay doesn't have too many places where you can learn that skill. So I learned the basics there for 6 months, and I had a lot of falls. Then I came back, then we continued, and you know, I mean, it's a 20-minute answer. I can't really sum it up for you, but you know, it was basically very difficult.
Thank you, Harsh. Thank you so much.
Hi, namaste.
Namaste. You both looking very stunning.
Thank you so much.
My question is for you and Harshvardhan both. As we just heard, Anil ji said that Kapoor Parivar has given a greatest contribution to the films. And so is you.
Thank you.
Your family is also very much connected and given a lot of contribution industry. आप दोनों कितना pressure महसूस करते हैं इस वक्त film release पर है और बहुत ज़्यादा लोग आपसे उम्मीदें रखे हुए हैं.
Ma'am, pressure तो मतलब I hope at least I'll speak for myself. If I kind of have 5% of the genes that my grandmother or my aunt has, तो ऐसे लगेगा कि थोड़ी बहुत acting आती है. But प्रेशर नहीं है क्योंकि दोनों हर्ष ने और मैंने वी हैव गिवन इट आवर बेस्ट एंड व्हेन वी हैव गाइडेंस लाइक राकेश सर गुलजार साहब इट मेक्स लाइफ मच इजियर सो वी हैव गिवन इट आवर बेस्ट एंड वी होप पीपल लाइक इट
मेरा सवाल हर्ष ऑन योर लेफ्ट
हर्ष अभी आपको जवाब देना बाकी है
कौन से क्वेश्चन का
Oh, God. Oh. Do you feel the pressure?
Yeah, no, I think, you know, I think when you kind of believe in something so much and you work for so long with so much honesty and, you know, you basically leave behind your life and you sacrifice so much. Eventually, when you're performing with that honesty in your heart and your mind, the audience can feel it in when they watch it. And I, you know, that's all you can really do. So I don't think it's very intelligent to feel creative pressure in terms of commercial expectations because you're somebody's son and all of that stuff. I feel there's nothing I can do about that. So whatever has to happen will happen.